And good morning. It's Saturday, the 13th of June, 2015. Good morning. Welcome to today. Oh, good afternoon. Welcome to today's United Kingdom Talk. Now, as it's the 13th, does that mean, do you have unlucky Saturday or not? Oh, it's a call already. That was quick. It's young Ryan in the Netherlands. Hello, Ryan.
Hello.
All right.
All right.
Can you just turn my sound on YouTube off?
What?
I can hear myself coming back. Can you turn my YouTube sound off?
Yes.
All right.
All right.
Yes.
How are you?
How are you?
Good.
This is young Ryan from YouTube, 11 years old, and he's started doing his own Periscope. I can still hear myself echoing. Have you got me on somewhere else, mate?
Yes, I are. I just had an accident with painting.
You just had an accident?
Yes. All the painting stuff throw out of... All the paint threw out of the bottle and it was all over the room.
Painting? Are you doing painting?
Yes, I was busy with painting a few things, like a fish.
Now, it was your birthday yesterday. Are you 12 now?
Yes, and it was everywhere.
Oh, what presents did you get? Tell me.
On the table, on the floor.
What, the paint?
Everywhere.
Well, go and clean it up then. You're sitting here talking to us while you should be cleaning the paint up.
Yes.
Go and clean it up.
I have already cleaned it up.
What did you get for your birthday?
I can actually show it, but I...
Oh, no, you can't show us on here because we're on the YouTube as well.
Now, so I can't get in the room.
Oh, okay. Well, I hope you had a nice birthday, Ryan, all right? Thanks for calling in.
Yes.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
There we are, young Ryan. Now, he does his own Periscope shows. If you're watching on Periscope, then you can find him. His name's Ryan, and I think he's 12 now. I'm sure it was his birthday yesterday. I meant to get a little cake or something like that. How awful to forget someone's birthday. It's not nice, is it? Forgetting someone's birthday like that. Now, where was I? What was I just saying? I can't remember where I started the show now. I said hello, I'll give you that. Yes, is Saturday the 13th? Is that unlucky? Does that mean it's unlucky if it's Saturday the 13th? I'm not quite sure. Anyway, a few bits and pieces to talk about this morning on our little programme, boys and girls. Have you ever had anyone stay that you couldn't get rid of? Now, where is this bloke? I've got to read you this. I saw this morning. Morning, Adam. I saw this morning on a Facebook post. I'll just bring this up and read it to you. And I want you to tell me... There it is. I'm not going to reveal the person's name. Neither day is unlucky, apparently. Oh, right, okay. Friday the 13th or Saturday the 13th. Nothing is unlucky. Nothing is especially unlucky when you're with us watching this programme. We are all lucky people to be here together. By the way, can you see something behind me there? Can you see something behind me there? You won't all know what that is. I will tell you later on. I'm not quite sure how that's looking to you. I get the feeling you can't quite see it. I don't know. You can see it's a glass thing. I have a feeling that's about all you can see. But you can see it, can you? Okay, well, I'll tell those of you that don't know what that is, I shall tell you a little bit later on. It's the most wonderful, wonderful thing. Okie doke. Now, listen to what I'm going to say to you. This was a post this morning on someone's Facebook. Here it is. Okay, I'm going to read this to you. Morning, Mike, and see if you can relate to it. A depressing story of the day. I'm really done doing favours for certain so-called friends. You try your hardest to help someone by letting them stay free of charge and rent at your home, free of charge and rent at your home, while they look for a place of their own. You cook for them, try to be as accommodating, friendly, and as helpful as possible for nothing in return for your trouble, and what do you get? Rudeness, bad language, the inability to understand what you say to them without questioning everything and taking it the wrong way and forming it into an argument, a bad temper, saying very hurtful things without a thought of how it can affect someone, then act as if nothing had happened. Continuously getting drunk, leaving lights on all night, costing a person extra money, using your personal toiletries, making a mess all the time without clearing it up and expecting you to do it, basically taking everything for granted. This person then finds a place to live and gets kicked out after only one night because the people said he was not compatible. Comes back to my place, finds another place the same day and leaves again that same evening without taking my advice of looking at another place I found for him. Then decides 4 days or so later he wants to leave that place too, goes on holiday for a week, comes back early, phones me saying he's lost his wallet, cash and credit cards. What does he expect me to do about that? Then after a simple comment from me, saying his voice on the phone sounded like that of another friend of mine, he then says, is that a good thing or a bad thing? Then turns it into an argument and says, I'm out of here. Then hangs up on me. And that's about it. There is a little bit more, but I don't think it's quite relative to the generalisation that I think I'm probably going to make here. But I wonder, have you ever had someone staying at your house, someone invited round because they are, and I quote, on more than one occasion, just need someone to stay for a couple of days until they sort themselves out. Have you ever had this? Adam's already said yes. I've had it many times, not recently, not in the last... not in the last 14 years, okay? The times I had helped someone out, saying that, I haven't got anywhere to stay. Rusty says the mother-in-law. Oh, Rusty. I love it. I love it. Simon says the other half, she won't go. But I've had this many, many times. And it's always the same. Can you help me out? I've got nowhere. You know, I need just a couple of days. I'll only be there a couple of days until I find myself something. They come in and that's it. You never, ever see them pick up the phone or go out and look for somewhere else. That's it, mate, they're in. And days go by. And weeks go by. The milk goes missing from the fridge. Isn't that the worst thing? You notice items of food keep going missing. Oh, can I put my washing in with yours? And it goes on. Never ever are you offered a single penny for anything. Never ever does a bag of shopping come back to replace the items that have gone missing. And of course, remember, they're not paying the bills. The lights are on. The heating's on. Everything's on. The telly's left on, unattended. I've had that happen several times, not in the last 14 years, because you know what? I put a stop to it. And even now, someone might say to me, oh, can I stay for a couple of days? Can I stay for a couple of days? The answer's no. Oh, go on, you know me. I'll be out after a couple of days. No. Absolutely not. Now, you might find that's rather harsh. You might actually find that rather harsh. But I've had it before. And then when you try and get them to leave, they make it feel like it's your fault, like you're the guilty one. You've helped this person out so many times. No, sorry, I've got that wrong. You've helped out so many people. So many times, And it's almost the same, not every single time, almost the same result every single time. Wendy says, once bitten, twice shy. No, it's not harsh. There's no way I would ever allow someone to come back here again. Now, I have one particular friend who's got himself into a little bit of trouble, who is in trouble now, right? And I've met him a couple of times. But that's a true friend, because not once has he said to me, can I stay at your house a couple of days while I sort myself out? No, he'll meet me, he'll have a chat with me and go off. Where does he go? Not quite sure. But generally, someone says that. Can I stay a couple of days? Just tell us up. No, they've no intention of going. I'm telling you that now. You must not take them in. Please don't. I know it does sound hard, you know, but you might leave them somewhere and they go wandering off and you think to yourself, oh God, should I have taken them in? You know, it's going to be the same result most of the time, I'm afraid. Ronnie's on the line. Good morning, Ronnie. Has this happened to you? Oh, can't hear you. No, can't hear you. Have I got everything on here? Oh, hang on, I've got a mute button pressed here. 1 minute. There you go, try now.
It's you, dear.
Oh, there we are, I've got
every
you now.
Every time you come round.
Sorry?
You won't leave. You just won't leave.
Ah, what do you mean?
I mean, you come round, I say to you, right, you've got a 30-minute window slot, and you're here for 4 hours. No, to be honest with you, many years ago, when I lived in London, I was going away on holiday.
Yeah.
And a friend of a friend was in a lot of trouble, and they had nowhere to go. And I said, well, look, why don't you stay at my flat while I'm away on holiday? I said, I'm away for 3 weeks, just a short break to the Maldives. And when I come back, you know, it's fine. But when I came back, the state of my home,
really?
They hadn't washed the bed linen. There was food strewn across the kitchen floor, broken eggs that had been spilled under the fridge that absolutely stank. Absolutely atrocious. Never again. Never, ever, ever again.
Is
never
that
again
only...
would I invite someone to stay in my home.
Is that the only because person just... you've ever had stay there?
Yeah, I just wouldn't do it. I just wouldn't do it. No, I mean, I had another friend who was very, very good. Who was very, very good. He was in a bit of a pickle while he was getting himself sorted. And admittedly, he did clean up after himself and stuff. He was very good. But this other one was atrocious. Absolutely atrocious. And I was really doing them a favour because they was in real, real trouble. They just lost their own home and they had nowhere to go. And as I say, I was going away on holiday and I thought I would do something nice and it all backfired. So I would never do it again. Never, ever do it again.
So, I mean, obviously they were also doing you a favour in this case by staying there while you was away. So presumably you didn't ask for any rent or anything.
No, I didn't know. Everything was all out of, it came about. I was at another friend's house and I've met these people before and they seemed very nice. And I just, out of, you know, a fleeting comment, I just said, well, look, I'm going away. I said, I can see you're in trouble. Stay at mine. I said, obviously, you know, you don't have to give me any money or anything. Don't worry about the gas and the electric bills and whatnot. And all they did was they went out and got drunk all the time and come back and just used it like a hotel. And waited for me to come back to sort it all out when I come back from holiday.
Did they leave once you'd got home, or did they try and stay longer?
No, they tried to stay, but I was like, no. Now I'm back because it was only a one bedroom apartment,
right.
So one bedroom flat. So there was no way that we could have stayed there because he was quite large as well. He was on the larger side, so.
Are you talking about yourself, dear?
No,
you're quite large, aren't you?
Luckily, I'm not talking about you. But,
there's a message here for you. Richard said, poor Ronnie, I think I'd chop... Oh, I've lost it. Just a second. Poor Ronnie, I think I'd chop him up if I came home and saw my house like that. It's just awful. Awful.
It is. It is awful. And it's not that. You do. You try to help people to the best of your ability. And 99.9% of the time... it's thrown back in your face.
It is. That's the sad thing about it. It's not.
And
it's not
awful.
It's not like unusual for that to happen. This I've spoke to many, many friends about this, and it's almost exactly the same reply. They get in and they won't bloody go. Get out.
Yeah, no. as I say, I had one good experience and one very, very bad experience. But on the face of it, I would never ever do it again.
No.
I would never let somebody come and stay here while I'm on holiday. Or, you know, I'm very lucky. I do go on holiday quite often to multiple destinations, as you know. And, you know, I've got you that come around and check on the cats, and I've got the God Botherer up the road.
God Botherer. You know, I'm a God Botherer, if you don't mind. I'm a God Botherer. Praise my soul, the King of Heaven. Hey?
But, yeah, I mean, it is quite awful. It is quite awful, you know, and it's not that. My home, you know how anal I am about my home.
Oh,
you're not even allowed
Christ.
To leave the house, dear.
Tidy all the time. You know,
yeah,
I mean,
the
thing is, do you actually look after that property? You know, I know it's yours and everything, but sometimes I come round and, you know, sometimes
of
I think to myself, well, that garden hasn't been cut for 2 weeks, dear. And because you're.
No,
nothing to do. Because you're waiting for the gardener. I mean, is that an excuse?
Of course
waiting
it is.
For the gardener.
I can't do it myself in the position that I'm in at the moment, dear. I'm not allowed to. I'm too posh to push.
Too posh to push, dear.
I am. I'm too posh to push at the moment.
Terry
not
says,
allowed to,
this
dear.
Is quite good. Terry says, believe in God, not religion. I mean, that's a whole different subject, isn't it?
Talking of different subjects.
Yes.
So this morning, I'm laying in bed, reading the newspaper, and the phone rings. Hello there. Is that Ronnie? Yes, it is. I'm just ringing about an accident that you had. Could you confirm the dates of the accident? I'm sorry, who's this? We're here to help you claim back. I said, no, I'm not interested, thank you very much. I said, the car was repaired. I said, and all damages were settled. Thanks very much for your time. Bye-bye. And
bye-bye.
Put the phone down.
Was that a quick phone down? I like that.
The phone rings again, and it's the same number. I pick up the phone. Hello? I've just spoken to you. We just need you to confirm. No. I'd like to know who you're from. We're a solicitors company that can help. And I said, look, I've already told you I'm not interested. So please remove me from your dialing list. I said, and we'll leave it there. I said, I don't want to be rude to you. Thank you very much. Have a nice weekend. Put the phone down. 30 seconds later, the phone rings again. This time I pick up the phone and said, I'm not interested. Beep off. And put the phone down.
Did you use a rude word, Ronnie?
I know, I didn't.
Oh,
I used,
my God, that's just awful.
And then the phone rings again. It's them again, demanding to know the date. So I just put the phone down and blocked them.
Good.
I mean, what is it with these cold calling companies?
Oh, I get it all the time.
Continually. I mean, my number's not in any phone book. It's not on any list or anything.
It's on a few.
It's on a few
walls, though, isn't it? In clubs and places like that. You've, for a good time, call Ronnie.
No, I don't think so, darling. I'm a lot more upmarket than that, darling.
Are you still getting those little cards printed and putting them in telephone boxes in London?
It shows the sort of establishment.
You don't listen. Shut up a minute. Shut up. Hello. Hello.
Now let me finish.
Did you hear what I said?
Yes, I did.
What did I say?
About the little cards, dear.
Do you put those in telephone boxes?
No, dear, I don't.
You know,
the thing is I had this before, and I actually spoke to an estate agent that kept ringing me, asking me if I wanted to sell my house and sending me letters. And I said, where did you get my details from? She said, you're on six different mailing things. And I said, well, where do they get them from? She said, the electoral roll. Anybody can access your details. It's disgraceful. I mean, what's happening in this country where you can't protect your own identity and be hassled and, you know, and all this aggravation? It's just wrong. Absolutely wrong, dear.
Well, of course, I get that all the time. People trying to impersonate me all the time. There's a lot of people that would like to be like me, to be honest, Ronnie.
No, there's not. I think you're a bit delusional there.
I mean, Simon Steele, for example, would like to be like me, like calm and collected. Simon is a very angry person. He's on the Isle of Wight.
Yeah,
I mean, you can understand it, really. You know, being on the Isle of Wight, he's a very angry person. I've just seen his work vehicle, and it never seems to move, and he seems to be on a permanent tea break all the time, you know, reading copies of the Daily Mirror and complaining about everything. That's the sort of person.
Oh,
Simon
God, how
Steele
awful.
Is. Well, thanks for calling in with that very interesting call. I can't talk much longer to you, you know, because, I mean, I've only just woken up and I don't want to fall asleep again.
Well, I was just also ringing just to let everybody know that I am slightly better.
Yeah,
I'm now running on about 47%.
Rusty says, if you give to charity, you get put on a pigeons list. I'm not quite sure what that is. Do you know what that is?
Yes, that is where they all end up calling you. Remember the old woman that killed herself?
Yeah,
Because of all the charities hounding. That is what that is.
Right.
There was an investigation quite recently. I think it was by the Mirror or the Mail or someone like that. I saw it on the news. And it's you know, the people are awful. I don't care if she's 98. She's not dead. She can donate more money.
Oh, dreadful.
This is the sort of thing that they say.
Yeah.
It's horrendous.
Yeah.
Absolutely
what
horrendous.
What are all money grabbing? All money grabbing people.
All
money grabbing.
Dear. I refuse to give to big charities because I saw another article and one of the patrons of the charity earns £170,000 a year. So your money is not going to the charity.
I hear what you're saying.
It's going to pay the... Now, where I come from, charity begins at home. You know, and if you do something for charity, you do it for nothing.
Yeah.
It's the same as... Do you remember when I lived in London? There was.
Well, I'd like you to remember that when you come round and have a look at my... and do my kitchen floor for me.
How dare you.
That hasn't been done since you last done it. How long ago was that?
I'm not very well, dear. I, you know, I'd really like to help you.
Oh, come on, a little bit of exercise will give you help, dear.
But as I was saying, you know, outside the Old Street Station, you used to get the chuggers.
Yes.
And one would stand at one end and one would stand at the other. And they was like robbers.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
One day he stopped me and he said, can I just ask you? And I said, yeah, go on then. And he started with a spiel about charity, this, that and the other. And I said to him, can I just stop you there? I said, are you getting paid for this? He said, well, what it is, and I said, no, it's a simple yes or no answer. Are you getting paid? And he went, yes. And I said, well, where I come from, charity, you do it for nothing.
Yes.
I said, and he said, well, how am I, you know, he said, I've got to live. I said, well, if you want to do something
go and
charity,
get a job then. Go and get a bloody job.
You go and get a job, you go and get a job, and you do this for nothing in your spare time. I said, you're not going to get a penny out of me. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.
Yeah.
And that was it.
Yep.
You know, it's wrong. It's
Terry,
all
wants,
very, very
Terry
wrong.
Wants to know if you're my brother. No, I don't have a... Well, I do have a brother and I don't. I was adopted, so I don't... I have a sister, that's it. So that's my sister.
We're not related, but
I have a half-brother from my natural mother, you see. So I do have a half-brother, but no, it's not my brother. Terry, that's my best friend. You were saying, Ronnie?
Yeah. Very, 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 very close friends. That's what we are, dear.
Well, thank you for
very
calling. It's been wonderful to talk to you, dear.
And it's been wonderful to talk to you, too.
You must try and leave a little gap in between while you're talking, though, so that other people can get in, you see?
Well, the thing is you might need to do that, actually, because you don't stop talking.
Because I have to fade you down sometimes, because they can't hear. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Oh, thank you. Bye-bye.
it does go on and on and on and on and on. Jesus Christ. Adam wants to know, Adam says, oh, Adam, I think you asked me a question. Do you want to just tap that back and I'll answer it for you? Adam only supports the charity UK Homes for Heroes. So that's Adam's one. I know at church we have, is that Cathoid? Cathoid at church or something like that? I think it's called Cathoid, and all the money that you put to them goes towards whatever they happen to be doing at the time. They do lots of different things. Cage. No, not caged. I think it's I bet it's Cathaid. Just a minute. Let me just type that in and see if I can find. Adam, what did you ask me earlier? I missed it. Sorry, I didn't write it back. Cathoid? Let's try Cathoid. No, it's not Cathoid. Cathaid, maybe. I bet it's Cathaid. Cathaid. Let's try that. No, it's not Cathaid either. Catholic Charities. Let's try that. Catholic Charities. Cafod. C-A-F-O-D. That's it. Cafod. Okay. Yeah. Cafod. Thank you very much. Yes. And there they do say... and no reason not to believe them, that any money that you donate to them goes to whatever is being donated at the time. Thank you, Shania, for that as well, Kath. That's the same one. I think that goes all around all the churches, doesn't it? Adam wants to know, how does the radio station work? You have to sit an exam. What radio station, darling? What? Try that again. Rephrase that quick. Adam, do you want to call in? Perhaps I can answer that question for you then. You can indeed call in, boys and girls. It's whoever calls in first, I take that call. You can't really call in while there's a call in progress, okay? And no one will answer it because it's me sitting here on my own. I know you think there's like banks and banks of operators standing by to receive your call in the love room, but actually it's me on the end of the phone. Or the Skype. Actually, there's no phone to pick up. I just push a button and you come up there. All right, the phone number, if you want to dial in, is a local London number. It's 020-8144-3477. 020-8144-3477. That's a local London number. I think Adam's about to call in first. Okay, we'll just wait for Adam. Also, boys, Deano says Ronny is very camp. Well, you know, no need to say the obvious there. And good afternoon to Mike, who's with us as well this afternoon. Good afternoon, Mike. Have I added you? Yes, there you go. You've been added. There you are, Mike. And Ryan was there as well. There's also a Skype in, boys and girls. If you've got Skype, the Skype username to call in is all one word, United Kingdom Talk, okay? Skype username is United Kingdom Talk. Those of you watching on YouTube may like to know, this show is also carried on Periscope. If you've got Periscope on your mobile device, the Periscope username is chrisreardonuk. C-H-R-I-S-R-E-A-R-D-O-N, UK. chrisreardonuk, all right? So once again, the phone number, 020-8144-3477. Come on, Adam, hurry up and call in. 020-8144-3477. Skype username, all one word, Chris Reardon UK. Or indeed, you can send messages on Skype. If you send messages on Periscope, I may miss them. If I miss them, just send them again. All right, and I'll try and come back to you like that. Adam, am I waiting for you to call in? You wanted to ask me something. Hurry up. Or we move on to the next thing and I shall miss you, dear. I shall miss you. Just saying about that moving in, when people move in business. I did have a very, very bad experience. About 20... Oh, dear, let me think. 27, 28, 38, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52... About 24 years ago, I had a flat in Wandsworth, which is in London. And I was seeing someone and I was with them for a period of time, you know, quite a while, and I moved in. And I went to work one night, I came home and see you later and all that business. And I'd left the keys at home. So I rang the door, no answer. I thought, that's odd. Rang the door again, still no answer. So I thought, well, that's odd. And I looked and the lights were on, all the lights were on. I had to go around to my mum's in the end and get my spare keys. Came back, let myself in. All the lights were on. The iron was on the ironing board. And the cooker was on. But he wasn't there. I thought, that's odd. I wonder what's happened here. And I scratched my head. I thought, what on earth has happened here? Because I was about 28 years old, that was. And it suddenly dawned on me, oh no. And I went to my place where I kept my, I didn't have a credit card then, checkbook and loose money and card for the checkbook. I rarely had loose money. I didn't have much loose money. Never really keep loose money anywhere, you know. I always go and put it in the bank. When I get paid, I got to put it in. That's where I'm going late this afternoon. I should go and put tomorrow's wages in. Adam, you can call in there. 020-8144-3477, Adam, all right? 020-8144-3477. Try and call in there. And, of course, I've gone there and it has all gone. It all gone missing and he'd robbed me. Isn't that awful? He'd been living with me for ages, ages. Anyway, so I rung up the bank. They told me not to worry, this, that and the other. And we realised after a couple of days, £500 had gone missing from the bank. that's an approximate. They were all little bits and pieces where checks had been written up. But the bank then wrote to me and said, we'll leave it a few days and see how much is taken out. We've received checks which shops had they had received checks from people that shops had accepted, right? But the signature, because at the time you'd have to have a signature, you'd have to have the card and the check. Well, he had both, right? But the signature on the checkbook looked nothing like the signature on the bank card. Now, the bank would have a copy of your signature because you would have signed something. So when the checks come in, they just put one against the other and say, that looks nothing like it. And of course, the bank didn't honour the checks going to these various shops. And they picked him up on it was a train ticket. That's where they started noticing that the signatures were on the trains. Indeed, at this particular train station, I think it was Waterloo, right? They had he'd paid for a ticket for somewhere, and they'd actually asked him to re-sign the check three times before they accepted it. I mean, how stupid can you be? You would imagine that once the signature doesn't look right, you would reject it straight away and not give someone a second chance. Of course, it's not like that now today. You have to have a PIN and all that business. But I had no problem in the bank immediately. It was very good. At the time, I was with National Gyro Bank. And they were very good. Immediately, they repaid my money. And I said, OK, will you be going to try and find and prosecute this person? I've no idea where they are. We will indeed, sir, but you won't hear from us now. That's from that moment, that's nothing to do with you. You've reported yourself missing. They've sent you the money back. Nothing to do with you anymore. Nothing to do with you anymore. It gets better. A few years later, quite a few years later, 10 years later, I'm DJing in this place in Ealing. And it was New Year's Eve. I always remember this. It was New Year's Eve. And this bloke come up to me and I thought, I recognise him. Hello, Chris. I said, all right. Okay, Adam can't call in. Oh, what a shame. Okay, Adam, not to worry. All right. He said, do you remember me? I said, well, you got a familiar face. But he looked old. He looked really old and thin and not well. He did not look well at all. I said, you got a familiar face. I can't quite remember. He said, it's Malcolm. And straight away I knew it was. Oh, all right. He said, look, before you say anything, I'm really sorry about what I did. I said, well, why have you come here? You know, now remember, I'm at work now. I'm playing to an amount of people. There's nothing I can do. Nothing I can do, even if I wanted to. And I said, well, why? He said, I don't know. He said, but they got me back for it. I said, what do you mean they got you back for it? Don't you know? I said, no, I don't know anything. You tell me. He said, I've been in prison. Have you? He said, yeah. He said, the bank came after me and they found me and they prosecuted me and put me in prison. And I said to him, well, it serves you blooming right. And I haven't been very well either. I said, well, that's the way it is. Anyway, off he trotted. Never saw him again. You know, someone on there said karma. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. Wendy says, John. It happened to John as well. Was that your... I'm so sorry, John. I'm not... Wendy, I'm not good with... That was your husband, wasn't it? John, or is still your husband, isn't he? Of course, you know. You knew that one. Was that your husband? Is that John? That happened to John. Wendy's... late husband, yeah. Yeah, okay, whatever. John had his house emptied as well by someone he let stay. Has that happened to anyone else watching or listening to the show today? Maybe you'd rather send in an email and tell us about it. My email address is chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk, OK? If you're watching a recording of the show, then the only way you can contact really is by email. I always read the emails out at another time, boys and girls. OK, chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk is the email address. All right, my darlings? Now, so that's it. Anyone else want to comment, perhaps on someone they've taken in the past and something like that's happened to them? You want to tell us? The phone number, 020-8144-3477. 020-8144-3477. The Skype in is United Kingdom Talk. Now, I want to show you this now, because Periscope people will have already seen this. Oh, by the way, Wendy says she's not getting notifications from me. Or indeed, anyone else, perhaps. Simon says, what a terrible story. So bad when your trust is betrayed. It's happened a few times, Simon, really. Not robbed, like, I haven't been robbed like that, only once. Friends who have betrayed your trust, you know? Maybe you've told them stuff, and I'm sure some of you can relate to this as well. When you've told a friend things, and it's kind of been used against you or for their own benefit or something like that. Phone call, is that you, Adam?
It is, Chris. Hello.
Hello, Adam. How are you? Got a bad signal there, have you?
I've got a bad throat, mate, yeah.
Where do you live, then?
Say again?
Where do you live?
West Ullage.
Oh, well, you should have good signal there.
I should have, but...
All those Dulwich people, they got loads of money there. You should have, like, 10G or something like that. I don't know.
Yeah, this is true. This is true.
Adam, you were just saying this has happened to you before, but that you've let someone start. Is it just one person or several?
It's happened before when I've had my own place.
Right.
I've let so-called friends stay. One run up a £200 phone bill for me.
Lovely.
One left the gas on all the time because they were freezing cold. And just turned on the heating when they wanted it and various stuff like that, Chris, you know.
Yeah.
So enough is enough. I can't do it anymore, you know. It's not that I'm not financially stable. It's just that I don't,
people taking the mick out of you. That's what you don't like.
Exactly, yeah. I don't mind if, you know, I've had genuine friends that have been in trouble, that have had breakups and they've stayed for a few days. You know, and I've come home from work and the house has been spotlessly clean because they've been sat there cleaning and doing stuff like that.
I don't mind having one of those in here. Have you got one spare?
This is true, Chris. This is true.
Just off. And you end up buying all the food and everything, don't you?
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
I did have two people, right? Two people staying with me in Wandsworth. They were friends. They didn't rip me off or anything like that. They didn't burgle me or anything like that. But they were paying a small amount of rent, and it was small. It was small, right? But for that, they seemed to assume that everything was included for that, and there'd be no food. There'd be no food. Yeah. And I never forget. You know what I did? So you know what I did? Yeah. And it took me a couple of weeks to do it. I ran down the food. Do you understand what I mean?
Yeah.
I stopped buying it and it went down. And eventually the cupboard was empty, completely empty. And I said, oh, are you going shopping? No, why? There's nothing in the cupboard. Well, go and buy something. We haven't got any money. Why didn't they have any money? Because they bloody smoked it and drank it all. That's why.
Great, yeah.
And they spent 2 hours trying to convince me. In the end, stupid old softy I was, I went out and bought some shopping, didn't I? Because they were starving hungry. But I didn't do it. I said, it doesn't include food, rent. Oh, doesn't it? No, it doesn't. They haven't got a clue. Not a clue.
Not good. You know, Ronny was talking about cold calling earlier.
Cold calling, yes.
Yes. I've got a classic one for that when they phone up. I had it happen to me a couple of years ago. And it was a conservatory company trying to sell me a conservatory. So I let the guy talk and done all his other bits and pieces. And he said, right, so can we send a salesman round to come and measure up? I said, yeah, of course you can, no problem. I said, I'll give you my address. I said, it's the 9th floor, Charlotte Despard Court, Battersea.
Adam, yeah. I'm just going to stop you there. Did you just say Charlotte Despard Avenue?
Yes, Battersea, yeah.
I used to live there.
Did you? Ooh.
St. George's House.
Ah, I lived in the other block.
My God. Probably not the same. That was 1983. I was married at the time, and we had a flat in St. George's House, Charlotte. What a dump. Oh, yeah. God, South what Chelsea. A dump.
South Chelsea, darling, South Chelsea.
So it's not. It was not. It was a dump. And actually, you didn't want to come out of your house after 7 o'clock there.
No.
Oh, my God, it was awful there. Awful.
Oh, I lived there back in 1997.
Oh, that was way after us. Isn't that funny? We lived on the same road.
So basically, that's the team. Yeah, you can come round. I said, ninth floor, Charlotte, Death Bar Avenue and Battersea. And he went, what? I went, ninth floor. He said, what do you mean ninth floor? This is a conservatory company. I said, well, can't you put it on stilts or something? You know, I said, I really want one. He said, I'm dead. I never got a phone call back from him again. And the other classic one that I really love winding these people up. The other classic one that I do is they phone up and they go for all their spiel and say, I'm terribly sorry, I'm not interested. Well, there's two things that I do. I either say, I can't talk right now, can I get your phone number? And they say, oh, sorry, we don't accept incoming calls. I'll say, well, give me your home phone number and I'll ring you after 6 o'clock tonight and see how you like and put the phone down on. That's one. Or the other one is I say that that my services to talk to them are £10 a minute. And if they want to talk to me, it costs them £10 a minute. And because their phone calls are recorded, they have to adhere to that. So if they call me again, I could actually technically bill them for calling me.
I love it. I love it.
They're really good ones if you ever get cold callers. I do love it. You know, or if you want to be on a slightly rude show, and I won't say anything rude, but being a Saturday afternoon, is I'm terribly sorry, but I'm doing the neighbour's wife at the moment. You'll have to call back.
You know what I do on cold callers? Most of the time, I admit, I just bang the phone down. There's actually a show. I can't remember when I recorded it. It's a long time. It's a few years ago now. Well, I was actually doing a show and the phone rang and it was something like that. And I gave him the address as 13 public, because he was foreign, you know, Bangladesh or somewhere like that they were calling from. Mm-hmm. 13 public convenience, off your head street, lavatory 7, 111 UFW.
Oh, God.
And he's sitting there, oh, just a minute, did you, public, can you spell that, please? And the other one I do is gobbledygook. So pretend you're the caller. Go on, call me and try and sell me something.
Good morning, is that Mr. Reardon?
Did you realize?
Hello there. I would like to see if you're interested in buying a new set of headphones.
I'm really busy getting them. Can you find a good seller? Very good, bye.
Oh, I see. Well, I can't really understand you, Mr. Reardon.
As you can imagine, and by then, they've usually gone, you know.
I'll have to start doing that with my back slang.
Because they're all idiots! Idiots!
Yes, yes, indeed. I'll have to start doing that with... I'll have to start... speaking back slang to them. That'll up them.
It's handy if you know a few languages. I think Chinese would be good. Wendy says she never knew I could speak Welsh.
The other question.
You had a question about radio or something, didn't you?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, no, I just wondered how it works with your when you're broadcasting on your UK channel, if you have to sit like a test to get the license, or you just broadcast on the internet, or how does it work?
Now, you mean on YouTube?
On the United Kingdom. Is that just your own channel, the United Kingdom Talk Radio?
I'm not quite sure what you mean.
Well, you know, it's United Kingdom Talk Radio, isn't it? Is that an actual...
United Kingdom Talk is the name of the show.
Yeah.
That's the name of the show.
That's your own show broadcast, is it?
Yes.
Is what I mean. You don't use another provider to broadcast for it. You just
the provider that broadcasts it is YouTube.
Oh, I see. I got you.
And Periscope. And then when I've finished it, it's uploaded to YouTube. and Facebook, and also a little thing called Libsyn. We're actually on iTunes. The audio version is on iTunes.
Oh, right, okay.
Have you got iTunes?
I have, yes, I've got.
Can you work it? Because I can't. I tell you what, perhaps you can help me with this. You know, I've bought a couple of albums, right?
Yeah.
Now, how do you delete the songs from it? There might be some, because I, you know, I don't want, I buy albums, you know, I might have 20 songs on it. I might only want five of them. How do you get rid of the other ones? How do you do that?
Do you know, I haven't worked that one out myself.
No. It's all very complex.
It's like, it's all very confusing sometimes, Apple, but I do like it, you know. It's like, I'd love to know, you buy movies from iTunes, you know, a full movie, like I bought Pride the other day.
All right. How do you watch that then? On a computer?
Yeah, you can buy films. You can buy, like, full films.
Right.
So, for instance, I bought Pride the other day.
Pride?
Yeah, Pride. I don't know if you've seen it or heard about it.
What's that about? Is that a gay Pride thing, is it, or what?
Yeah, it was basically about the miners' strike in the 1980s.
Oh, yes, because the gays supported them, didn't they?
That's it, yeah, the right. Lesbian Welsh Mining Group. That
okay,
was it.
Yeah.
And I fully downloaded that onto my iTunes account, so you can watch it anytime on the computer or through the TV, but I want to know if you can actually put it onto a disc, so you can sort of, you know, take it around to a friend and watch it, sort of thing, or have you got to drag your laptop with you all the time?
Yeah. I mean, Terry's just messaged, you can get Amazon on some TVs, Amazon do
yeah.
Now, what's that called? Amazon Prime, it's about 75 quid a year, isn't it? Which I suppose isn't that bad if you use all these things.
Yeah.
But I wouldn't use it. I know a lot of people have got the Netflix. But so your question is, can you download a movie from iTunes and put it on a disc to put in a DVD? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, that's it.
Right, I don't know.
Yeah, I was wondering.
I don't know that.
No. It'd be an interesting question.
Yeah, maybe someone knows the answer to that. Can anyone? Yeah. Does anyone know if you can do that? Download a movie from, pay for a movie from iTunes, download it and put it on a disc to watch it in a DVD player. Can that be done? It probably can. Whether it can be done legally or not, I don't know.
Well,
no idea.
I would want to say legal and above board.
Yeah.
You know? And just finally, Chris, before we go, you know, we were talking about the black cat the other day.
Yeah.
It appears somebody's occupied it. Some Occupy London group.
Oh, yeah, there's squatters in there at the moment, aren't there?
Yeah, which is really worrying because obviously, this, you know, the pictures and that we were talking about still might be in there.
I don't think that will help. And, you know, if there is the small chance that maybe it will open again as a reformed smaller black cat, perhaps as just a bar, I'm not so sure that sort of thing will help. You know, squatting in a place and this, that, and the other. And also, you know, the people that go in there and squat. Yeah. Are names taken? Do they know who they are? So that in the future, would that be a problem to them? Don't know.
Who knows
really how that works?
Well, I mean, my main interest, Chris, is obviously, as you know, is to try and save the interior photographs that are there, Mrs. Shufflewick and Regina and all that.
Yeah, well, I'm sure they've been taken down by the previous management and will appear somewhere at some point, you know?
Well, we hope so. Let's hope so, because they're decent things that are lost forever, right?
Yeah. All right, Adam. Lovely to talk to you there, all right?
All right, speak to you soon. Take care.
Have a nice day. Thank you.
Bye.
Adam down there in Dulwich, which is a very, very nice part of the world, really, Dulwich. Oh, yes, indeed it is. Now, can I show you this little thing behind me? We've not done everything, have we, that we were going to do today? Where's my little bit of paper there? Oh, yes. Oh, yeah, we've got to do that. We've got to do that story there. Right, now look at this. Now I've got a bit of tissue here because I don't like to touch it, because this is a very beautiful thing that you may not have seen yet unless you've been watching the Periscope shows, because it was on there. Look at this. Now Wendy sent me this. Look. And it's quite heavy. Actually, I've actually ordered a turntable for this. Okay. I'm not exactly sure how it's all going to work, but the turntable says maximum of 1 kilo, and I'm not sure that this is going to be a kilo. Oh, someone else is calling in. Let's just grab that call there. Hello there. Good morning.
Hello, it's Deano.
Morning, Deano. Can you just hang on a second?
Yeah.
I'm just showing them this glass thing. Have you seen my glass thing?
I can see it, yeah.
Oh, you can see it. There you go. That's it there.
What and is
when,
it?
Wendy sent me this. It's a glass cube, like rectangular cube thing, like a crystal. I think it's crystal or... must be crystal. I don't think you'd do this in glass. And in there is my United Kingdom Talk logo, 10-year anniversary, which isn't until October. I don't think you can actually see that, can you? You can't. It's difficult to see.
Turn it towards the screen a little bit more.
If I hold it at an angle, yes, it's crystal.
Oh, yeah, there you are.
Is it a type of... you can just about see the logo in there.
Yeah.
And it's just beautiful. And Wendy sent, and it's got the logo in there, and underneath, 10 years anniversary.
Wow. It's beautiful.
It is just stunning. And with that also, I've got a card. And what I've done is put it on top of a little light-up thing that I've got here, which I think does it justice, actually. That does do it justice, doesn't it? You can see, depending on what colour light... sorry, those of you that just listen to the show can't see this. But what was that?
I've got mobile phones going off all over the place.
Was that a message from one of those many dating sites that you're on, dear?
Oh, no. I've given that up. It's on a Saturday. I'm a good Jewish boy. We don't do anything on a Saturday.
Oh, fair enough, yeah. I know that, because I've been to Israel, you know.
Have you?
Oh, yes, last year. Lovely.
I didn't know that.
Oh, I'd very happily go back there.
I've never been.
Have you not? Oh, you should go. You'll love it. You would absolutely love it. All that history. You don't need to be religious to go there and see it all, you know. But it's all there. And all religions. The Jewish history, the Christian history, the Muslim history. It's all there. Just amazing.
You see, even though I'm Jewish, you see, my ancestry is... my grandfather was part Russian, part Polish. I'm talking about from sort of early part of the century. My grandmother was Dutch. And when they were fleeing Hitler during the war,
oh yes,
they met on the boat coming over. That's how my grandparents met.
Oh, how lovely.
Quite a lovely story. All the men have got dark hair in my family, and all the women are blondes.
Okay.
Buxom blondes.
And what happened to you? Because you're grey.
I'm not grey. I've got natural, flowing, beautiful brown hair and hazel eyes.
I just got this other little thing from Wendy as well. Which is very similar to that one. But this is a key ring, and it is a key ring, but I can't use it in case it gets damaged. Right? And this actually lights up. It's got a little light in it, a little blue light in it. And you can see the logo on this one. Beautiful little thing. You can't see it because there's a bit of a delay between when I see
it. I know, you're laughing at the moment on the screen, and I'm thinking, what?
You'll see the key ring come up in a minute. It's just beautiful. And she sent me a card as well. Can I just read this out and then we can have a little chat? Where's my card gone? Just a minute, let me put this. I'm so frightened of dropping anything here because it's all like... now, where's that card? Oh, here's the card.
Jesus, that is a delay.
Yeah. Oh, that's quite normal on the internet with that stuff. And a card says, friends are the sunshine of our lives. You are the sunshine of my life. To Chris, thanks for brightening up my world. Hope you like the gift. Lots of love.
Don't try ever doing karaoke.
Lots of love from Wendy. So that's really kind. Thank you, Wendy.
She's really sweet. She follows you, doesn't she? She seems like a really lovely lady.
Oh, she's a Manilow girl. That's how we met. I've made quite a few friends through Manilow, really.
Did you ever go and see him in Vegas?
Yes. Yes.
And what was that like? I bet that's phenomenal.
It is. It's not there anymore. But he was kind of talking about considering going back there if he got the phone call. Don't know anything. We don't really find things out until they're about to happen.
It's really funny because they all do Vegas. I mean, when I went to Vegas, I absolutely adored it. It was amazing.
Well, what did you see there while you were there?
I didn't. I basically went out to see to Lonnie. I went out to Lonnie Gordon and I stayed with her for just over a month, which was amazing, up in the mountains.
Yeah, there's a few young people. So just to let you know, Lonnie Gordon was a pop star in the 80s, 90s. Had quite a few songs out. Deano, who you're talking to who we're talking to at the moment, manages her a little bit when she's over here, don't you?
So we went up in the mountains, and I spent most of the time actually up there, and it was just breathtaking. And when you got down into the city, it was just so crazy at certain times of the day.
Yeah.
And some guy came up to me and he said, Actually, on my last trip, I took my mum and dad. And on the last trip, my dad wasn't feeling too well. So we were making our way back to the hotel. And this guy came up to me and said, I've got two tickets left to see Bette Midler. Would you like them? I'll give you them for $10. They were selling them at like $400 or $500. And I said to my mum, I'm not going to go on my own. I said, let's take Dad back to the hotel and you come with me. I said, it's a once in a lifetime thing to see Bette Midler. And she went, oh, no, no, no. I went, no. You're going to come with me, aren't you? She went, no, 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 no. I said, I can't. I've got to go back with your dad to the hotel. He's not feeling too well.
Oh.
So I didn't go. I was so annoyed that I didn't go. I should have just taken myself off and gone there.
Well, while I was there, I saw Barry. It was a really fantastic
first name times.
I saw Elton John.
Oh, wow.
And I was in the same room as, are you ready for this?
Go on.
Liza Minnelli.
No.
Liza Minnelli was 20 feet away from me. I was breathing the exhaled air of Liza Minnelli. How fantastic is that?
And the alcohol.
She was great. Now and again, she'd be halfway through and she'd have a coughing fit, but it doesn't matter. It's Liza Minnelli.
Wow.
Liza Minnelli. It's like, do you remember that title? Oh, Bette Midler apparently is due on a UK tour soon, says Wendy.
Really?
Yes.
That yes. I've got to say.
I'd like to see Shirley Bassey.
I saw her at the Roundhouse.
Did you really?
What was it, about 2 or 3 years ago? It was amazing. And it was broadcast a couple of nights later on BBC. But that was phenomenal. And do you know what surprised me more than anything else? The amount of straight people, the women and the men that were literally were dancing around the handbags to all of the Shirley Bassey tracks.
Yeah.
I was like, wow.
Well, my one of the bosses of somewhere I used to work, Vicky, her name's Vicky, she's not there anymore, she was at Belushi's in London Bridge. When she left, a new bloke took over, he got sacked within 2 weeks, and then another new one took over and got rid of all the karaoke, so that's why I'm not there anymore. He just didn't want karaoke, end of story. But anyway, so Vicky, she told me this story. Her dad once took, I think it was her and her dad went to see a Shirley Bassey concert. And her dad is like proper Yorkshire man, quite, you know, real man. And he's sat next to this. Oh, have you gone? I've lost him. Damn, I've lost him. We've lost that call. Anyway, I'll finish the story off for you, boys and girls. there he is. He's back there now. Did you not pay your bill?
I did. You just stopped talking.
I stopped talking. I've been talking for ages. 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 Anyway.
Go on.
Where did you get to? Where did I get to?
You got to the new manager.
Right, okay. So Vicky and her dad went to a Shirley Bassey concert. So they're sitting there in his crowd. And her dad has sat next to this young gay bloke. And Shirley Bassey, and her dad was a proper real man, Yorkshire man. You know, yeah, all right, mate, and all this business. And they're sitting there, Shirley Bassey's come on. And this queen suddenly grabbed me like, oh, my God, look at the frocks. And her dad was absolutely bricking himself.
Oh, my God.
How funny is that?
Well, this was the thing. Well, we were looking at these really sort of macho-type builders, and they were all like going all zushy. We were like, no, I was watching them more than I was watching Shirley Bassey.
Oh, I know
so
what you mean,
funny.
Dear. I know.
It was so funny.
I have my mate Ron is the worst one for that. His wandering eye is obvious. Do you understand what I mean like that?
So there might
be a couple of blokes trying to have their breakfast in Waitrose or something like that, and he will be staring at them. Staring to the point of me being embarrassed.
Why are they eating their sausage?
Oh, it's awful. That's awful. Stop it now. Stop it.
Okay.
Well, it's nice to talk to you, Deano.
And you, I was going to talk to you about something else, but you're running over time, aren't you?
I am now.
All right, I'll catch you. When are you on next?
What is it you want to say? Come on, we can go.
I wanted to tell you about very quickly about cold calling. And I wanted to tell you that I had a cold caller and I got I was got quite annoyed with one of them, and she said to me, if you don't believe who I am, call me back, here's my number. And I thought, oh no, this is very unusual. Anyway, I rang her back, and it turned out it was genuine. It was actually from my bank, and I got a refund on PPI of £22,500.
How much?
£22,500.
Dino, I've always liked you. And I do feel that we should go out and have a little meal or something like that and talk about a good way to invest that money.
Well, do you know what? I've already invested it. I'm moving out of London, and I've just bought a house out in Surrey. So I'm on the move in a couple of weeks.
Where?
So it's already been invested. I'm moving to a little place called Whiteleaf, which is just by Caterham.
One moment, please. You're going to be close to me.
Why, where are you?
Bracknell.
Oh, yeah, of course. I spoke to you the other day. I was out looking at houses near Bracknell.
Well, you should have come here.
I can't remember what the name of the place was. Newhaw.
Newhaw, yeah, I know. Is that where you're moving to?
No, I looked at some houses in Newhaw.
My uncle lives there. Newhaw, he's got the canal at the end of his garden.
It's a beautiful place.
So where
absolutely
you,
beautiful.
Whiteleaf, is it?
Yeah.
Whiteleaf to Bracknell, let me see. Let me just see. One moment, please.
It's probably down the M25, isn't it?
All right, that don't look right. Whiteleaf, that says it's not near Oxford. That can't be the one.
No.
Whiteleaf in Surrey.
That's it.
Is it Whiteleaf?
No, it's Whyte.
White.
Leaf.
Oh. Whiteleaf to Brack. Now, one moment, please. Trying to connect you. You are, oh, blimey.
Yeah.
1 hour away?
There you are, you see.
Oh, you're beneath Croydon, aren't you?
It's kind of Caterham. Don't say Croydon. That's a dirty
Well, I'm
rival.
Sorry. It says Croydon here, dear. Don't try and make it up better. It's like the other bloke we were just talking to, Adam, on here. When I said that's in Battersea, he said South Chelsea. No, it's not. It's in Battersea, dear.
Whiteleaf is in Caterham.
Whereas Bracknell is in Royal Berkshire. Did you know that?
Royal Berkshire. That's not far from Milton Keynes, isn't it?
Yeah.
There you go, dear.
What, Bracknell? We're nowhere near Milton Keynes.
Of course you are.
That's Buckinghamshire, dear.
Yeah, maybe in a different borough, but it's down the road. It's like where I used to live. I used to live in... I've just moved to another house temporarily, and across the road is the borough of Lambeth, and on the other side of the road, it's the borough of Croydon.
There's not much difference between the two.
My friend across the road lives in Lambeth, and I was living in Croydon.
What about the Isle of Wight? Do you fancy living there?
No. In actual fact, I went to look at a house which was in the middle of an island in Windsor, actually on an island, and the only way you could get to the house was via a boat.
Oh, yeah. What's the island called?
I don't remember the name of it. This was about 2 months ago. I saw it on the internet.
I know. Really expensive.
Oh, it was amazing.
Hang on a minute. Island, Iceland, in the Thames. Where about? What county? Surrey?
It was in Windsor.
Windsor? Let's have a
look. Oh, it was phenomenal. Find that.
Is it Monkey Island?
I'll just type in what's for sale on Monkey Island.
Okay.
It was phenomenal.
Monkey Island. There we are. Let's have a look there. Is it in Bray? No, it's not Bray, is it? Monkey Island Hotel. I don't know. No, I don't know.
I'll have to send you the
but
link.
Yeah, I've seen that on the television. It's got a little... And you have to get a boat to it. How lovely.
It
You'd never
amazing.
Get burgled, would you? You'd never get burgled there.
No, you wouldn't. Not unless you were... unless you were someone like Tom Daly and you swam across. There's another story.
Maybe I'll come and visit you one day. You can swim across that Thames.
When are you next over in South London? You don't do anything over here now, do you?
No, because, well, I'll be doing a new thing in Sydenham.
Oh, yeah, you said, because that's down, well, that's, at the moment, it's down the road from me.
That's not far from you at all, Sydenham, but it hasn't started yet. They're having a refit. What happened? The cherry tree was sold, so they've now moved out of there, and they've got a new place in Sydenham, but they're not ready there. So.
What happened to Gabby?
Who?
Gabby.
Gabby? Oh, yeah. My God, that drag queen Gabby, she moved to...
She was mad.
Oh. Margate, I think. But now she's come back and she's kind of looking around for work still. She's
the maddest drag queen on the earth. If anyone here has never heard of Gabby the drag queen.
Gabby drag queen,
look her up. She's mental.
Yeah, she is indeed.
Right, I'll let you go because you're running over time.
Thank you, Deano. Thank you for talking to me.
You be good.
Cheerio.
Bye.
There we are. Nice little run of calls we've had today, haven't we, boys and girls? And that's it for the show today. Thank you very, very much for joining me. I don't think we've got any late shows this week. Let me think. What day have I got? Sunday. I've actually got a day off. I'm really looking forward to that. A day off tomorrow. Sunday. A day off. I haven't had a Sunday off for ages. So I'm looking forward to a little Sunday off tomorrow. Monday I'm working, Tuesday, I've been asked to go back to the Golden Lion in Camden on Tuesday to do karaoke there because it's like a darts team party, not playing darts, but that's it. And on Wednesday I'm going to an opera this week. Wednesday going to see Ace of Hearts, something like that, a Tchaikovsky opera. I've never been to an opera. I'm very, very excited going with Ronnie to that one. So that's my week ahead. So don't think we'll have another live long show like this. Of course, there'll be lots of little Periscope shows between now and next week. If you want to join me on Periscope, download the app for Android or iOS, iPhones, that sort of thing. Download the app Periscope and add me. My username there is chrisreardonuk. chrisreardonuk, my username on Periscope. Shania says, I hope we have more altar servers at the church tomorrow, because they were a bit sort of altar servers last week, weren't they? Hardly anyone there. Thank you very much for watching and listening. I'll see you soon. All right, my email address, chris@unitedkingdomtalk.co.uk. Have a nice Saturday. Bye-bye now.